So I told her I'm not going to buy any more. Shiny. Let's have a look in the box. Finally turned up the Tamiya F-35B Lightning II 1/48 scale. Oh, it's lovely. It looks right nice. So been waiting for this for a while, and yep. And oh, with this we can display it in three different ways. We can get that on the camera, so you can have it in flight, just landing, and stationary. Yeah, and I believe you can have it in beast mode. Yeah, that's right. So the actual what they got it there displayed is as parked, short takeoff, and vertical landing. Very nice. It's very nice indeed. So let's get the camera changed round, and we'll go down and have a look in the box. Yes, it's a big box. It just about fills the screen. Well, it does fill the screen more. Yeah, been waiting for this for a while. Had it on order for some time. Saw it at Telford and it was like, oh, very nice. So I must admit, I have had a little peek in the box. Just have a very quick little peek. But I'm going to put some blue paper down. And we'll get the pieces out and we'll have a closer inspection. I'm excited. Can you tell? Right, so here we go. What's in the box? Please excuse any rustling of the plastic bags. I'm opening it for the first time. Ooh. Look at that. Looks very nice. It's very nice indeed. Right, so I'm, like I said, I've only just opened this up just to look through. I haven't actually opened anything. So I'm going to put the bag box to one side and bring in the sprues. Now, like I say, please excuse any rustling. But this is our first bag. Now, I'm going to zoom in a bit so we can see the detail. I just need to bring the camera that way a bit. So, staples. I hate staples. I just don't understand why you have to have staples in kits now. Don't need it, do we? Wow, look at this. This is very, very nice. Nice detail. And the fact that the whole top section is one complete piece. Yeah. It's very nice. We've got the main one, which is the main fuselage, and then the wings are on separate. So you're going to have a join. You know, considering that this is one composite piece of material in the real thing, you should never join. So interior, yep, that looks nice as well. Got a bit some obviously in there which may be used or may be used for attaching stuff, etc. But yeah, and although this is raised, it's hardly at all. You can feel it, obviously, but it's not ludes. But yeah, we've got nice detail. Yeah, so there you can see we've got the fan, because this will be used for the short takeoff. It is the B version. So yeah, let's just put that one to one side. So next sprue. Why do they put blooming staples? So this is our lower section, so it's in two pieces. Yep, I'm not gonna bend that too much. And yep, again, detail is lovely. Again, one piece, so you're not gonna get any join line between the wings, because as I said, again, it's one composite piece of material. But yep, very nice. Looks like we've got area there, which will be for, let's turn it out the right way, it might help, for the ladder for the pilot to get in and out of, areas for bomb bays, etc., and landing gear, missile compartments. Yep, it's very nice. He's really nice. Next, boom. Oh, so this one isn't the man. I haven't got a knife because I was a numpty. So please excuse the state of this hobby knife. This isn't one I really use, but all my tools are in the house because I'm just doing some modelling in the house at the moment, because it's way too cold and that knife couldn't cut through butter. So I'm going to have to stretch that a bit. So this is sprue. Oh, so yeah, this is sprue V, and you can see we've got all the ducting, fans, intake, and that's the bit where it sits in, that sits on top. I'm not sure what these parts are, but then we've got panels which can be opened. Obviously this is part of the fan as well. Various compartment doors to open, and more bits and pieces there. Like I say, I don't know what all these bits are, but very, very nice detail. Very nice indeed. It's looks rather good. It's on both sides there for that ducting there. So yep, that is very nice. Again, superbly molded, absolutely superb. So let's come out for the next sprue. And we shall bring, oh, and this one has got a staple in it. One has staples, one doesn't have staples. Very inconsistent. Now then, oh, that's coming a bit more again. So now this is, must be for the jet exhale in, or is it intake? I'm not sure, but a lot of air intake, or it could be the exhaust area. But very nice, very nice indeed. We've got landing gear. Now with the landing gear, there's two options, so just go in there. So this one would be for if it's parked, because there'll be weight on the actual piston, and this one is if it's, you've got it displayed on the stand, so obviously the wheels would be fully extended. So that's very good, very good indeed. Detail there. And then we've got a rear one, so I presume we've got another two sets to come. We've got some more panels which must open up, but the detail on there is, that is very good. I know the camera is struggling and I do apologize for that, but I've tried to put it on this blue paper to make it better, but very good. Now this, I'm presuming, could be part of the cockpit, or that could be the inside of the front landing gear, not sure. We've got a fan there. This piece is purely a cockpit piece. Well, it would help actually if you had it right way up, wouldn't it? There you go. So I'm guessing this is the bottom of the cockpit area, because this piece must be the internal of the front landing gear bay. Yes, so here we've got some nozzles here. They look to be the same, not sure. Some more detail on there. So I'm not quite sure where this piece goes, but we will find out. See, there we've got an instrument panel for the cockpit, and there's more cockpit detail there. Very nice. Then we've got two frames for the cockpit housing glass. Now, yes, I see. So this one will be if it's closed, the cockpit door is closed, and this one is if you're going to have it parked and have the cockpit open, because there's a piece there, so it would sit at an angle. So very nice. It's very nice. Nice, lots of detail, lots and lots. I'm going to enjoy building this one. Next bag. This one has staples again. So this is, I didn't say this last sprue on last sprue, I'm sorry, but this is sprue T. Now then, this will be the ducting for the exhaust out, going out the rear jet. So this will be with it fully down, and this will be slightly raised, and then that will have it straight. And then we've got the various different parts that you can put to do that nicely in the different positions. And then this is the internal, like, air intake for it. Yep, very nice. More details on this exhaust area, a fan detail there, and this piece again, I'm presuming this piece goes on the rear for the exhaust, and very nice slide molded. So yep, lots of detail indeed, definitely on both sides. So you're not just gonna have one side with detail, it's all on inside and externally. So yep, it's another fabulous sprue. Now we've got a couple of smaller sprues again, I mean staples. Can you tell that I don't like staples? Come apart. Thank you. So, two sprues in this bag. We'll just put. Are they identical? Yes, these are identical sprues. They're both called sprue C and sprue P. So we'll just put one to the side. Right, so here we have weaponry. Nice weaponry. So this is the the mounts for the missiles, etc. If you're going to have it in beast mode, yep. And these are different bits of ordnance. Some more bits there for the air, either intake or the exhaust at the rear. Some various pieces there which are going to attach onto the aircraft itself. Then we have a wheel, some missiles, I presume they're air-to-air missiles, I presume they go on the end of the wings, perhaps. So the landing wheel is in, obviously it looks like it's going to be in two halves. Now this one isn't weighted, so we'll see that, but that is the first wheel I've actually seen, so we don't know if any of them are weighted or not. But yeah, very nice detail, mounts there to attaching the missiles or the ordnance. Our next sprue. Let's open up. Right, so this will be our right way up. This is sprue U, and this will be our rear tailplane section. Here and here, and I think this will be flap for the air intake when it's doing its vertical land and short takeoff, perhaps. Yep, not sure what these pieces are, but we will find these all out in instructions. So very nice indeed. Not much detail on the inside of that one, so perhaps there's a piece that goes on top of that to give detail. But as a whole, looks very nice, nice and smooth surface on there. Some very low raised areas, but like some of them just stand up so much. Our next sprue. And this one has not got any staples, so we've got to use this dodgy knife. And like I say, it is a dodgy knife. Now it's gone so sharp, it's probably gone through the paper. So, right, so we have, well, let's start with this bit. This must be part of the landing gear area, the rear landing gear. Excuse me. I have no idea what the actual pieces are. Do apologize. Looks like we've got this will be, I believe, the sort of like opening hatch, which is where the ladder will come out of, which is there, I believe that's the ladder for the cockpit to get in, cockpit for the pilot to get in. Looks like this is possibly cockpit detail, I'm not sure. We have a wheel. These are two halves of the wheel. They're not the same wheel, but it's only one half and one half. That makes sense. We have our pilot. Looks very nicely molded. Arm and a head. Not sure what these parts are. Then we have some more like internal doors, etc. Bays. Looks like this is our cockpit seat. Some more pylons, and then we've got some pistons, etc. To one of these parts are at all. Then this piece, I'm going to turn it over. Oh, we've got more cockpit detail. Looks like that piece repeated again, because we've got one of those already, but I'm sure. Maybe I'm wrong. So yeah, so there's the internal detail of that door, and this would be the cockpit area. So yeah, I presume that goes into there somewhere, and that will go over the, that's a shroud that goes over that cockpit area. So we've got some detail, internal detail there for the seat. Yes, so that shroud there goes over that once it's in place. So yeah, very nice. But this, yeah, all looks some lovely detail here as well. Wow, not sure if that's will be seen or not, but I'm guaranteeing, well, this will be, this area will be for sure. Next sprue. And this one is stapled. Boom. Dump. And just slide that out. Right, so this is sprue. Let's get the right way round. Sprue number R. And first, you're just drawn to this straight away, aren't you? Just wow. Look at all that detail. That is sublime. Wow, that is absolutely superb. We have some fun painting there, aren't we? That's wow. So then we've got another piece here. I'm presuming from the shape of it. No, never presume anything, Steve. You should know that by now. But perhaps that goes there. And then we've got some more workings. Nice there. Some more panels that probably open up or will be closed. Again, there's more there. Some more internals. More internals. Oh, some very fiddly looking pipe work. That's very nice, very nicely detailed, very, very good. And some more pipe work here. And there, yeah. So let's just turn that over. Now, see, I'm presuming that this won't be seen. But if it is or isn't, I don't know. But there's detail there. It looks like it might be seen, but I don't know. Until we come to building it, I have absolutely no idea. But it looks very good. Because, yeah, you can see that there's detail there. Which, why would you put that if it wasn't going to be, if it wasn't going to be seen? So it must be seen. We shall see, we shall see, he says. But then we have our last grey sprue. Again, stapled. And then again, this is our tailplane area, our verticals, stabilizers, some more areas here, flappies perhaps. Then, oh, this is sprue E, but I want to get that staple out of the way. So here we have another wheel. Not sure what wheel that is. And then we have the landing gear again. Now it looks like these struts are suppressed, as in this would be in the parked variety or stand. Maybe I've missed, but I've only seen two rear wheels, as in two halves. Maybe I'm wrong. We'll have a look. We'll have a back look in a second. So then we have got canopies. I'm not going to open these, but it's going to be difficult for you to see, I know, but the transparent looks very good from there. If I put the knife under there, I know it's going to be hard to tell because we're actually looking through the plastic bag as well, but we have two. They're both tinted. Not sure what the difference are. There obviously is a difference. Yes, this will be when the canopy is closed, and this one will be when the canopy is open, he says. No, I thought there was a bit of plastic there to have it down, but no, I can't quite tell what the difference is. Q and Q, they're both called Q, so, and that's one and they're one, so apparently they're exactly the same. So not sure why you'd get two canopies. Then we have, I'm not going to take this out of the bag either, but this is our display stand, which we can have it, if you're going to have it in the vertical takeoff mode and vertical landing mode. So looks very nice. Let's put that to one side. Then we have another sprue with clear pieces. Again, I'm not taking these out, but yeah, they look nice and clear for that piece. Then the rest is slightly faded, and I presume that's correct because there are various clear pieces in there which are actually clear. So yeah. And then we have our instructions in this massive bag, and it's quite a big bag of instructions. I will zoom out a bit. So yeah, and we've got a little baggie in there with some metal rods, and we've got a screwdriver and a screw, nut and bolt. So that's interesting. We'll go through those in a second. And then last but not least, we have our decals. I will open these up. Oh, bloody staples. Why? Tell me why. Not that they're going to be listening to me on my channel, but hey. So, we have canopy masks. Masking stickers, it says. So they look very nice. You just got to cut those out with a nice sharp knife. Then we have a piece of card. This must be our stencils, or decals. The stenciling area there. We've got a UK flag. We've got Marines, because you can do this in a number of varieties, as in who flies it. Then we've got some light grey details there. Oh, so perhaps they're saying, because you've got quite a few there as well, that rather than paint them, you're going to decal them, you know, some of those raised bits areas. So, but we shall see. We've got some instrument panel areas there. Various markings. Like I said, we've got the British flag, or United Kingdom, should I say. Then we have, let's just take that one out of the way so we're not interfering too much. Then boom, 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 boom. So here we've got Royal Air Force. So yeah, so it's the Royal Air Force emblems there. Then we've got Japanese air defense systems, we've got Italian air, and US Marines. So yeah, nice decals. I'll put those just in the box for now, and I will come back and put these all back in the bags in a little bit. So the instructions. This is quite a hefty bag, really, for all these instructions, etc. And reading material. Oh, yeah, we've got some advisory information there in various languages. This is our little baggie with a screwdriver. It's a tiny little metal piece there. It's like possibly a magnet. Not sure, but we will put that in the box so we don't lose it. That's the sort of thing I do. Then, let's just put that to one side. We have some information. Good luck at trying to read that. And then we've got no chance. So I'll open this up. Yeah, so you can see Yep. It's very detailed in there, doesn't it?
Ah, I've just spotted something.
Right, so now we have it in the English. Hooray! Well, it's English and other couple of languages as well. So we have the information. The Lockheed Martin F-35B Lightning II specifications. Its wingspan, its length, its height, its crew, maximum speed is Mach 1.6. Engines, and then this is good, he's actually telling you all the different bits of information about parts around the plane. Obviously I'm not going to tell you everything, but it's very good information. And then here we have the internal laws of fanning. So that bit, which I thought went the lid, actually goes into the lid, is the lift fan. So yes, very vane box nozzle. So that obviously opens up underneath. So obviously, yeah, very good. Some roll posts, it says, well, a roll post, drive shaft for that, moving nozzle. Yeah, that is some very good information there. Very good indeed. Let's just close that up properly. Then we have our next booklet. And this is the instructions on building. So, first of all, we've just got some safety information, tools you're going to need, a colour call out, and, well, there's a lot. There is a lot of colours to call out. Wow. And there are X's as well, and not just XFs, they're X. So you've got like the gloss black, gloss white, orange, chrome silver. So yeah. So yet again, I've been a numpty. My daughter phoned to say she was on her way home from school, so I had to just stop the video recording, spoke to her on the phone, and then carried on. But I didn't start the recording again. So I'm having to just do this last bit all again, because yes, I'm a proper numpty. So we got to the part where it says there's a lot of X numbers, as in the gloss colours, and we also have, let me just zoom in a bit. No, it's not going to focus, is it? Because the auto balance, yeah, it just wants to keep going stupid. So I'm just going to pull it out a bit. No, that's too far out. Hopefully that's not too bad. Right, so we got all the X colors, which are the gloss colors, and then we've got a hell of a lot of the XFs, and it's also got some LPs in there as well, AS and some LPs. So it's all the AS26, it's calling this light ghost gray, so unless that's one thing. But as I said, the instructions, I don't know if I did say not, I can't remember now, but this is one hell of an instruction sheet panel, booklet. It has in total 59 pages, and yeah, it's wow. So with this kit, we have the option to build it in three different versions. We have it in parked, short takeoff, and vertical landing. So the difference being, parked is you can have the canopy open, the ladder for the pilot to get in and out of, and the fact that the nozzle, the engine nozzle, is just straight, just sticking out backwards, straight. The short takeoff is the fact that the lift fan doors are open, the auxiliary air intake doors are open, the underneath the lift fan doors are open, and the taileron are down, and the engine nozzle is slightly down, so it's just push them down a bit. Then we have the option of the vertical landing. So pretty much the same here. There. The nozzle is down, completely facing down, and then we have these open as well. They're just open in there as well. Sorry, I forgot to mention that bit. There, the engine nozzle is down. So that's the difference. The three ways it can be displayed. Obviously, you've got your various beast mode, stealth mode, fighter attack mode, etc. So the first of the instructions is calling out paint, and it's also saying to make some holes inside of the can, inside of the main fuselage. Then we're just adding some bits and pieces where we've drilled these holes, and we get color call outs for painting these as well. Then we go into the cockpit. Building the cockpit together, we've got the paint call outs, we've got a number of decals to go in as well. So you're going to probably need some proper decent micro set and sole, and we've got the pedals going in, detail painting on some more of the cockpit, etc., etc., all going in, side panels going in, we're painting as well. And then you can see that is attached from inside off the top part of the fuselage. We've also got the fan going in, which is, this is the reverse side, and it's telling you what color to paint, etc. there. Then we have the nose, we have the nose landing gear bay. So we've got some bits and pieces going in, and as we said earlier on, I didn't know quite what it was, we're attaching the nose landing gear bay. Part of this goes into here, so that's what that is. But that is the actual nozzle or the air intake part, which I wasn't quite sure what it's going to be, but it, there we see what it is. Then with this model, like I say, you can have it in part vertical landing, yeah, or part short off of vertical landing. And with that, if you're going to have it parked or the short takeoff, the gear is suppressed. If it's in the vertical landing, the gear is out, stretched out, so the piston is right out. Now it's giving the various collar call outs, and then it's also saying if you're going to have the landing gear up, to put it in here like this. Not sure why you'd have it like that if you're going to be displaying it, but there must be a reason. Then we're moving on to the lift fan underside, and we're assembling the pieces going on there. That's like, let's say, the nose gear housing. Then we move on to the front of the top half of the main fuselage, and we're attaching that in. The nozzle's going in, or so, yep. Then it comes to the air intakes. We're getting paint call outs for the various sections in here, and yep, that is very nice. Then we're assembling it all. We've got the fan going on the back. I believe that's some kind of piston, I could be wrong. And then we've got some bits and pieces going in. Then we're attaching that to the front section of the lower hole. Lower fuselage, if you want to call it that. Yeah, lower fuselage, not hull. And then we're attaching this piece to the top part of the fuselage. So you've got the air intake going in, and there's above of it's going on there. Now we're working on to the underneath part of the lower fuselage, and we're just going to be doing painting of this pit at the moment. And we're also now drilling out some holes. Drilling the holes out are for versions A, B or C, and that would be for stealth mode, air-to-air mode, or beast mode. Beast mode being all the weapons, air-to-air missile just being missiles, and then stealth mode, nothing, everything's internal. And we've got some color call outs and some decals to lay in as well. And now this is that landing gear bay area, which is just, and it's also the weapon bay as well, shall I say, or is it just the weapon bay? Oh, I can't remember. But it's detail painting, a lot of detail painting going in there. It's immense. And then we've got more, so we're not actually even putting anything in here at the moment, we're just literally painting. So a lot of instructions there on how to paint this. This is going to be a cool kit. It's going to look so good. So I think that is why I'm going to be definitely doing mine in the vertical landing. So you can maybe see some of that, maybe, possibly not. Right, then we're doing the nozzle base, which is on the rear of the plane, obviously. Duh. Just doing some bits and pieces in there together. Now we're assembling the weapons bay. All the bits and pieces going in, etc. So much pieces going in. We've got more colour call-outs and painting details. Very, very interesting. And we've got some weapons bay two is putting on some more pipe work. More detail stuff going in with more painting. And then we are attaching the display stand nut holder. So that's good. So that will stack, that's like how it's going to stand on that display stand we saw. Then we're attaching the weapons bay to the lower half of the fuselage and the nozzle, the rear nozzle. Then we're attaching a spar which goes across, which holds it all in place, I presume. Yep. Again, more detail painting of bits and pieces inside. And then we're attaching the two halves of the fuselage together. And then we've also got like the attaching the weapons bay, side panels, etc. Now, this is the interesting part. As I said, you've got three different versions to build. So we've got the part version. The part version is from pages 26 to 65, I believe. No, it can't be. Maybe, oh, I don't know. Maybe that's stages 65. Yeah, that could be stages 65. Duh. But yeah, so you can see it's going to have a quick show of what it's going to be like, as we showed in the first picture. Canopy up, steps down, nozzle horizontal, everything else is closed up. So we are building the nozzle on the back, so we're building it straight, attaching these pieces, attaching the nozzles to the fuselage, and then the nozzle doors, etc. So these are closed, so that's why we're doing that version. And these other pieces going in here. Then the landing gear. So as I said, the landing gear is going to be down but suppressed because of the weight of the aircraft. We've got various call outs, the color call outs, etc. And then we're placing the landing gear in the into the lower fuselage. Then we have the wheels. We've got the color call outs for the wheels, gluing the two halves together. There's no weighted wheels in this from what I can see, so not sure. I don't know if it had weighted wheels. Maybe it doesn't have weighted wheels, the aircraft. Maybe they've done that much. I don't know, I could be wrong, probably am. Right, now we're attaching the landing gear covers, all very simple, and then deploying the nose landing gear. So it looks like you can have it in or out, depends on how you want to do it. Interesting. Now we're doing the nose landing gear covers, all the doors, putting them in. Then this is the front intake or exit, shall we say, for the fan is closed. Attaching more pieces and pieces, we've got some the EOTS sensors going, putting in with the glass bit and masking off, etc. Then we have the weapon bay sidewall parts going in, and more detail painting of that as well. Then we have the central weapons bay doors being assembled and then attached. All very nice. Again, all colour call outs, etc. So a lot of painting to be doing, hand painting and maybe airbrushing as well. And then we've done the RAM launchers, the launchers, should I say, the AMRAMs. Then we're attaching some launchers on here. And then we're building the JDAMs. It's a GBU-32 JDAM bombs going in. And then the AIM-120C's AMRAM missiles. Again, colour callouts, decals, the same on here as well. So it looks very interesting. Again, now you're deciding what you're putting on, so what weapons loadout you're doing. Now we've got the outer weapons bay doors being assembled, and this is where that metal rod comes in. This has got the metal shaft, so that goes in, so it can be, I presume, opened and closed, maybe, maybe not. And then we're attaching the outer weapons bay doors. Yep, and then we're attaching, I do find this funny, flapperons. Yeah, maybe they are called that, I don't know, but it just seems a bit odd. And then we've got the landing gear edge flaps, and then we've got the tailorons. Again, sounds a bit funny, but maybe it is correct. Then we're attaching the flight control surfaces. Then the missile launchers all been attached, to paint callouts as well, etc. on here as well. And then it's the sidewinders are being attached, or are being built, should I say. And colour callouts, you've got the decals to go on there as well. And then we're attaching the sidewinders onto the pylons. You're going to make two of those. And then we've got the GBU-12 paveway two, again building the color callouts and decals, then attaching all those various bits of ordnance, and then onto the actual wings underside. And then it's attaching the vertical stabilizers, again callouts, etc., color callouts. Now this is a callouts for the cockpit, different colors, so I'm not sure why they're showing it again here, because we've already built it, but maybe, I don't know. Ejector seat, bit odd, because you've already built the ejector seat, I thought. And oh no, we haven't actually built the ejector seat at all, we've actually built just the cockpit detail. So now we are building the ejector seat, my bad. And all the colour call outs, this is a decal by the looks of it, so I'm sure someone's going to bring out a PE set for that perhaps. But you're only applying the decal if you're not putting in a pilot. And here we've got all the painting instructions, colour call outs for the pilot. That's going to be very tiny to do because it's 1/48, but hey. And then we're attaching the ejector seat in, and then placing the pilot. And then we have got the shroud for the instrument panel, we're doing the painting, and the decals going in, the ladder going in for the pilot, etc., the door. And then we're masking off the canopy. Different decals to go on, call out for that frame to go underneath, and then we're attaching it. So that would be, if you're doing it on a parked version, that's it. There we've got the call outs for the short takeoff version, and this is section 66 to 104. So as you can see, we've got the air intake up there and there, the nozzle is slightly down, the canopy is closed, and there's no ladder, as you can see all in here. Now, and I say this is exactly the same, obviously it's not exactly the same, but it's slightly different, but the principle is the same. It's just the nozzle is slightly different, the way it's loaded, the way it's actually built. It's rather being straight, we've got that slight incline down. Then again here we're attaching all the different pieces, again all the different color call outs. We are doing the nozzle doors because now these are going to be open and they're put into place, and you can see then we're attaching the actual nozzle to the fuselage and the different bits and pieces there. Again, now we're coming on to the landing gear, and just forgive me one second, sorry. Yeah, the landing gear, again this is heavy, as in it is closed up on the rear, so yeah, perhaps it's just closed up whether it's the rear or not. I didn't actually notice that actually. Then we're attaching the rear landing gear, doing the wheels, etc., and attaching these various pieces. So this bit is fairly similar, same with attaching all the doors, the landing gear in the front, the front landing bay covers, etc. Here exactly the same, but on here we're attaching this piece, which is the cover for the fan, and then we've got those bits that are open there. So these are attaching the lower lift fan doors. They are being painted, and we've got some decal to go on there as well, and they are displayed open. And then again we've got the EOTS sensor, exactly the same there. Again, the weapons bay sidewalls, exactly the same. The weapon bay doors, again exactly the same. The flapperons that's funny. Again, the landing gear flaps, then the tailerons, again this is all exactly the same. Again there as well, the same again. Then we're doing the missile launchers and all the missiles, again this is exactly the same. We've got all the decals, the call outs, and then if I can turn the next page, again exactly the same on this here. This is the GBUs, the paveways. The paveway twos have been attached, placement onto the wings for beast mode, and then we're doing the vertical stabilizer and attaching the vertical stabilizer. Again exactly the same in the other. Again, the ejector seat built the same, the pilot obviously the same. It's got different decals and color to go on there for the various types that you're doing, because obviously they're all not going to wear the exactly same uniform and badges for the various different the various different countries that have the aircraft. Again, attaching the ejector seat and the pilot, and then again we've got the instrumentation panel, auxiliary air intake doors are attached this time because they're open, so yeah, that's different. We're also attaching the lift fan top part, so we've got the call out for that, and this will go on there. This I believe is white, it says X18. I'm not entirely sure what it is, but I'm not sure. X18, what is X18? X18 is a semi gloss black, so that's that bit, isn't it? Yes, XF2 is the white, which is a flat white. Yes. Then obviously this is going to be open, so we're building the upper lift fan door. We're putting in the decal for the various nations that are flying the aircraft, whichever version you want to do. We'll be doing version E, and then the canopy is exactly the same. Then we have the vertical landing, and this is one that I think I want to do. I'm pretty sure, or it might be the short takeoff version, I'm not sure, we shall see. But the main difference here again is the nozzle. As you can see, it is fully 45 degrees down, no, 90 degrees down, shall I say, 45. Excuse me. So then again, building the nozzle bits, these are the same. It's just mainly this bit which is different to get the angle there. Attaching pieces on there, these will probably be slightly different because they won't be seen on the other one. Again, call outs, the nozzle doors again, so this is the same. Attaching the rear nozzle to the back of the fuselage again. Landing gear, all exactly the same. The wheels, the decals, the color call outs, the main gear covers, again the nose gear and the nose gear doors. It seems like I'm skipping through this, but it is pretty much repetitive on this side, on this part of the things again, because we've got the fan sense, the fan bit going on, lower fan. We've got the EOTS sensor, masking again, weapons bay side panels, weapons bay doors. Again, this version has the lower lift fan doors, call outs, decals. Again, all the missiles and ordnance is all the same. The ailerons and flapperons, tailerons, and flight control panel services, missile sidewinders. Let me turn the page again. He says, again, doing the loadout, the vertical stabilizers, the ejector seat again, and the pilot again, installing the cockpit ejector seat and the pilot. And I'll say this is exactly the same again. We've got all the more controls for the cockpit. We have the air intake doors, which is the same as the short takeoff version, exactly the same again there. The door for the lift of the fan door, again the different call outs for the different nations. Masking of the canopy, painting, etc., what to cut off. And then the bit that is different is how to attach the stand. So we're using the screwdriver in there again, the bolt screws, and we've already placed a bit inside, so it should attach very nicely. And how it goes in there and displays it very nicely. And that is the then you've got some information about decals, etc., and the painting. And there you go. So that is a very thick instruction manual. Very impressive, very impressive. You've got a nice picture on the front. Then we have these. So this is the stencils, and it's a huge sheet. I'm gonna pull right out, and yeah, it's huge. This could actually be to scale of the kit. I'm not sure. It looks like it does look very similar size. But so you've got all the stencils called out, where they go. Obviously this is showing the doors and for the fans being closed. Yeah, so a lot of stencils, and like it says there, it's for A, B, C, D, E, F, and G, so that's for all versions. Then we've got decals, and this is for version A and B. A being the Wake Island Avengers, Commander Jet, United States Marine Corps, cross-deck operations. And version B being Wake Island Avengers, United States Marine Corps, first combat deployment. That's the So the A were actually on cross-deck operation on HMS Queen Elizabeth, and the B version is on, we're on the USSS Essex in the Middle East, 2018. So yeah, so you could actually build A version and even though it's not the RAF, it is one that went on the, that was on the HMS Queen Elizabeth, the new carrier. Then we have another sheet. These sheets are very big. Now, so this is for C and D. So C is the BATS Commander Jet United States Marine Corps operation aboard JMSDF Izumo, Pacific Ocean, October 3rd, 2021. Okay, and then D is BATS United States Marine Corps Air Station Iwakuni, Japan, April 2023. So that's actually this year. So it's probably one of the newest versions. And that is C. And then we got the other parts of the decals for that one there. Then we got version E, which is the one I shall be doing, which is the number 207 Squadron Royal Air Force operations aboard HMS Queen Elizabeth, October 2020. So yes. And let's just, did we do that one? This is F, and this is 4th Carrier Air Group, Italian Navy. It's all the different decals, etc. And then G is 32nd Wing Stormo, Italian Air Force. I'm going to butcher this name, Amandella, Air Base 2022. So, we've got two versions for the Italian Navy as well. Well, the Italian Air Force Navy as well. So, yes, that is our done. So we will go back up to the other camera and carry on. Well, that is wow. There's the detail in the instructions are tremendous, and the detail on the actual kit parts is wow. You know, I know they say Tamiya kits are very, very, very good details, and this is going to only be my second or third Tamiya kit I've ever built. But it's actually, I think it is my third. Yes, definitely my third. Because the first one was the 148 Spitfire, and then I've built the 148 Chally 2 desertized. So I'm pleased, I'm blown away. So that's a very nice kit. We should be starting that next year, early next year in the new year. I'm going to build that alongside the Meng one. Looking at it, I don't think there's any comparison. Obviously the Meng is the A version and this is the B version, but the detail is just it blows the Meng one out of the water completely. But hey ho, we shall see. Well, we know we will. So I'm just gonna say thanks for watching, thanks for joining me on this box opening, or what's in the box. And stay tuned for the next video. If you like what you've seen, please give it the old thumbs up. If you're a subscriber, thank you for subscribing. If you're a new subscriber, welcome along, thank you very much. And in the meantime, stay safe and happy modeling. Bye bye.